Late-night hosts on Tuesday addressed Project Veritas' attempted sting operation on The Washington Post, in which a woman approached the newspaper claiming she was impregnated by Roy Moore in an effort to get the Post to publish her false claims. "This is a strange time to be a journalist," Trevor Noah began. "On the upside, there's so much news every day. But on the other hand, whenever you do your job, even when you do it right, people call your work fake. Right?" Double quotation mark. "We're seeing it now with The Washington Post," Noah went on. "They meticulously researched and then broke the story of Roy Moore's history of allegedly sexually harassing teenagers. And then Muir accused the paper of making it all up. Yesterday, The Washington Post broke a real fake news story." Right? Double quotation mark. Noah then explained how the Post came to recognize the sting operation when a woman named Jamie Phillips approached the paper saying she was impregnated by Roy Moore as a teenager and later had an abortion. "This Jamie Phillips is nefarious. Creating a bullshit story to give to a newspaper so that when they run it you can claim that the news is full of bullshit," Noah said. "I wonder how the Post was able to see through her sinister plan to combat the mainstream media." Right? Double quotation mark. He then analyzed many of the holes in Phillips' story, including glaring inconsistencies in her statements to the Post and a fundraising post by a woman of the same name, in which Phillips writes she's accepted a job for a conservative media outlet to combat the lies and deceit of the liberal MSM. If you're wondering what's the story behind Jamie Phillips, she's part of this thing called Project Veritas, Noah explained. It's an organization devoted to exposing the mainstream media. The founder is a man named James O'Keefe, a conservative activist, and Ouchie Michael Cera. Right? Double quotation mark. Project Veritas first made a name for itself in 2009, when O'Keefe took down a community voter registration group called Acorn, Noah explained, adding that O'Keefe, infiltrated Acorn offices, had to pay Acorn $100,000 in damages for illegally recording conversations. Since then, he's only gotten worse at his own game, Noah said. He tried to tap a senator's phone and got arrested. He phoned a liberal nonprofit posing as a donor, forget to hang up, and then they heard him talking about his scheme. Every time James O'Keefe tries to expose the mainstream media, he ends up exposing himself. This is another example of how people like this, Project Veritas, Roy Moore, Donald Trump, are much less interested in the truth than in discrediting all the sources of truth. Right? Double quotation mark. Seth Meyers of NBC briefly touched on a number of topics, including North Korea's latest missile test, which their government claimed to be successful on Tuesday night. "President Trump commented on North Korea's missile launch saying we'll take care of it," Meyers began. "That's it? I have to say, I don't find it comforting that the president talks about enemy missiles the same way a dermatologist talks about a weird mole." Right? Double quotation mark. Trump spoke to the press today between two empty chairs designated for Democratic leaders Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi after they pulled out of a meeting with him, he continued, showing an image of Trump beside two empty chairs where labels for Schumer and Pelosi remained despite their absence. "Look at him. He looks like the guy who shows up early to your dinner party while you're still slicing bell peppers." Right? Double quotation mark. Finally, Meyers referenced President Trump's inflammatory references to Pocahontas, the nickname he's used in the past to mock Senator Elizabeth Warren, and Eric Trump's defense of his father. Eric Trump tweeted today that he found it ironic that an ABC reporter was insulted that President Trump called Senator Elizabeth Warren Pocahontas, when his parent company, Disney, profited off the 1995 movie of the same name, Meyer said. He also found it very ironic that Pocahontas was the movie his father took Ivanka to see and not him, and also why doesn't his father ever return his calls. Right? Double quotation mark.